body of one organism, one bud comes out. So that bud, the genetic information from the main cell, main body, main organism, it is transferred to the bud copy. That means DNA copy is transferred to the bud, and gradually the bud also become larger. And when it will become like a new individual, it detaches from the mother's body, and from that a new individual is developing. So that is the budding. So then vegetative propagation. So vegetative, that word means, vegetative word is word means the body part. So that is why this vegetative propagation is mainly shown by the plants. So in this case, what happened? From the body parts, vegetative means body parts, and propagation means development. So from the body parts, if a new individual is developing, then we can say that is a vegetative propagation. So many examples are there. Cutting is there, layering is there, grafting is there, tissue culture is there. So many examples of vegetative propagation is there, where we can use the body part to develop a new individual. For a very simple example, I am telling you that one rose plant is there. You just cut one stem of the rose plant and you dig in another place, then you will see that from that stem a new rose plant will develop. So that is a very good example of vegetative propagation. Again, you see bryophyllum, that is one type of plant. Okay, so in bryophyllum, what happened? From the leaf only the new individual is developed. So if you take the leaf of one bryophyllum, then if you keep it on the soil, so after a few days you will see that from the leaf new individuals, new seedlings or new saplings will arise. So this is also another example of vegetative propagation. And lastly, it is given the spore formation. So in this process, it is also one type of asexual reproduction. Here some spores are formed, and that it is mentioned here in page number 132. You see, it is mentioned that I'm reading, the thread-like structures that developed on the bread in activity 8.2 above the hyphae of the bread mole, that is a rhizopus. So this the blobs are sporangia. That means it is giving the example of one particular fungi, that is rhizopus. It is developing generally above the bread. If you are keeping the bread for long time, overnight, if you are keeping the bread without covering it, then this one type of fungi is developing there, that is the rhizopus. So this rhizopus, when it is developing, if you see under the microscope or under the any magnifying glass, if you see, then you will see some spore like structures there. So that are the spores which are forming the new rhizopus or new fungi. Okay, so this spores, they are developing in a particular location, that is said as a sporangia. Okay, so in the sporangia they are developing, and they are helping in the formation of new plant. So it is one example, it is given the mole, or you can say the mucor. Afterwards, we are getting the sexual reproduction. So I already told you that for this type of reproduction, the gametes are required. So briefly, I would like to tell you the gametes are nothing, that is a cell which is taking part in the cell division, and they are having the half number of chromosomes than one usual cell. So one usual cell contains 10 chromosomes, then the gamete will contain 5 chromosomes, so that means half of that. So it is very important, and gametes are generally of two types. One is male gamete and one is female gamete. So male gamete is produced by the male body, and female gamete is produced by the female body. So male gametes are also called as sperms, and the female gametes are called as the ova or egg. So that is the brief information about the gametes. Afterwards, in case of plant, it is mentioning. So first of all, you know, plants, the sex organ of the plants, it is the flower. And this flower, most of the flowers are bisexual. That means they're the male part and female part together. So the male part of the flower, we can say it is the androecium, or we can say as the stamen. And the female part of the flower, we can say as the gynoecium, or we can say the pistil. The male part of the flower, that is androecium. Androecium contains mainly two parts. One is the anther and another one is the filament. So anther is the place, it is like a container-like structure where within which the pollen grains are developing, and pollen grains contains the male gametes. Understand? So, and this anther is attached to the flower with the help of one another structure, thread-like structure, and that is said as a filament. So, one androecium, or we can say the stamen, contains two parts. One is the anther, another one is the filament. Same way, the gynoecium, that means the female part, also said as a pistil. It contains three parts. One is stigma, another one is style, and third one is the ovary. So, stigma is the front part. So, where, you know, the pollen grains are falling, that is the stigma part. It is like this, where the pollen grains can be stored or can fall there. And this stigma is connected to the ovary through one tube-like structure, that is said as a style. And through the style, the pollen tubes are developing. When the pollen grains are falling on the stigma, then the pollen tubes are developing. And that pollen tubes are going to the ovary through this style. Then the ovary is there. Within the ovary, the ovule is there. And within the ovule, the female gamete, that means the eggs, are produced. And then this thing about the pollination. So pollination is what you see, the process by which the pollen grains are transferred from the anther to the stigma of a flower, that is called the pollination. And this pollination may be self or it may be cross. That means in self pollination, the pollen grains from in the same flower. I already told you that most of the flowers are bisexual. So in the same flower, there is a anthers are produced there, and in the same flower there is the stigma. So from the anther, the pollen grains are coming to the stigma in the same flower. If it is happening, then it is said as the self pollination. But if it occurs in between two flowers, that the anther of one flower goes to the stigma of another flower, then it is called a cross pollination. And the another flower may be of the same plant or maybe of different plant. Okay, so this is called cross pollination. And for cross pollination, some agents are required. Otherwise, you know, from one flower to another flower, the pollen grains cannot go. They need some medium through which they can go. So that medium, that media, may be wind, may be rain, may be water, may be birds, may be insects, may be human, like you say, or maybe another animal. So some agents are required. Okay, so these agents, what they are doing, I think all of you know that, let for example one honeybee is coming to a flower to collect the nectar. So when they are sitting on the flower, at that time the anther, their legs and their wings may come in contact with the anther, and from the anther the pollen grains will get attached to their wings and their legs. And from there, as after that, when they are going to sit in another flower, at that time this pollen grains along with their legs and wings, they can be transferred to the other flower. So like this pollination occurs. So this is called as a cross pollination. So if it is asked about the difference between the self pollination and cross pollination, so then you can write that self pollination occur within the same flower. That means during self pollination, the pollen grains from the anther goes to the stigma of the same flower. But in cross pollination, the pollen grains from one flower goes to the stigma of another flower. So that is cross pollination difference. And secondly, you know, for self pollination, agents are not required, but for cross pollination, agents are required. So that differences you can write there. So then after the fertilization is there. So when the pollen grains are falling on the stigma of a flower, after that the pollen tubes are developing, because within the pollen grains the male gamete is there. So pollen tubes are developing. Through the pollen tubes, the male gametes, they go to the ovary, and within the ovary there is the ovule. I already told you. So in the ovule, the egg is already there. So this male gamete will go, that means sperm will go and fuse with the egg produced in the ovule, and as a result of which the zygote is produced, and that zygote later on it develops into the seed. And the ovule along with the ovary, it will develop into the fruits. So like this, fruits and seeds are developed. So this is enough only, because this 8.3.3 reproduction in human beings, this part is not required for this year. So I hope you understood, and if you are not understanding, you let me know by giving me comments here below this video, or you can directly WhatsApp me in my personal WhatsApp number. Thank you and have a good day.